In this video, I'm doing another t-shirt design tutorial in Canva so you can make a t-shirt that looks like this right here. This is a fun one to do. I'm gonna show you how to do masks and other things in there that you may not know about. So let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and my channel is all about helping you to learn how to design and sell t-shirts online. If that's something you want to learn how to do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button right there. So in this video, I'm doing it again. I'm going to go into Canva. This is totally free. I'm using the free version of Canva, and I'm going to show you how to make another t-shirt design. In this one, I'm going to show you a couple of fonts that I used, and I'm going to show you how to do masking. So in my last video, I kind of just covered things to mask it. There's actually a way to mask things in Canva that's really easy. They have lots of different shapes that you can use. And this tutorial, you can follow along step by step. There's lots of different things that you can use if you're on the pro version, but I'm gonna use the free version to show you that you can do some of the things in the free version as well. It's gonna be a pretty quick tutorial, and hopefully you can use these same techniques in other designs that you're making in the future. So let's get to Canva right now. So here I am on Canva. You can see I'm using the free version, it says free right there. All I'm gonna do is start with create a design right here and custom size. And I'm gonna use that 4,500 by 5,400, which is the Merch by Amazon size. So I'm clicking on that. Okay, and let's get started. The thing that I wanna do is do an anime, but first I wanna do a mask. So the first thing you wanna do is click elements and do frame. Type the word frame right here, and you're gonna see all these things. You can put pictures in these frames. It's pretty cool. So you can pick any one of these. I'm gonna scroll down and look for something pretty unique. Let's see. I love these kind of brush shapes. I'm gonna look for one that's kind of tall. You can see you can put it in letters and numbers, just tons of things, right? Lots of different things here. Scroll down. You can put it in other things like this. These are really cool. You could use for t-shirts as well. And all of these are free. That's what's cool about it. All of these frames are free. So let's do this one. This one's kind of unique. So take a look at that. Really unique there. I'm gonna make it as big as I need to, so maybe something like that. Okay, so I can just throw in a picture here, but it's gonna mask it, so I'm gonna need two of them. So let me do one more. I'm gonna click on it, hold down option and drag. You can see now I have two. I'm gonna just put the other one here. I'm gonna color the other one a background color, and let me just pick a color. So remember the eyedrop. You can do this and pick one of these light colors. That's cool. All right, I'm gonna look for anime drawing. So I'm gonna just type in anime. That's the thing about Canva. You can look for almost anything here and they have it. Here's a free one. A lot of these other ones are pro. Let's just look at graphics. So a lot of these other ones are pro. And if you are on the pro version, you got so many different options. I don't have that many options for the free version. I got this one right here. So I'm gonna drag this one into there. You can see it's masking it already. If you wanna move it down and change it, click on it and hit crop, or you could just double click on it and drag it like this. It's basically doing the same crop. So I just wanna see the eyes and the face. So you can see right there, there's guides to tell you where to put the eyes and face, kind of centering it so you don't lose it. I'm gonna do that. Let's see what that looks like. Yeah, so it's cropping it out. You want this above this color. This is gonna be in the back. So position back like that. And we'll just move it so it fits. There you go. That's pretty cool, right? And if you want the face bigger, again, you can click on it, hit crop, and just make this big like that. I think that would be really cool. Let's do even bigger, so it's just the eyes. Yeah, that's pretty cool, right? Okay, so the next thing I wanna do, I'm gonna color the background so that we can see what it would look like on black. So click the background, and let's just pick black here. Great, because black shirts sell really well on Merch by Amazon and other print-on-demand spots. So let's put in some text here. I'm gonna go to text. I'm just gonna type in heading right here. And I'm gonna write, I just. Now I want a font that matches anime. So I found a few. I'm gonna just put it here. The first one that I found was called Lazy Dog, so I'm gonna type in Lazy Dog. And you can see it's just like a handwritten font. And I want that white so I can see it. White. Okay. Just there. And I'm gonna move this down and then find another font that kind of matches. Just gonna copy this for now and then type really love. Whoops, I gotta spell it right. Really love. I'm gonna use another font just kind of to give it some balance, to give it some interest. So instead of Lazy Dog, I found this other one that's kind of rounded. It's called Bjork or something. Let me, B-O-R, Borsak, Borsak, Borsak. I just really love like this. And I'm gonna curve this just a little bit. And remember how we do that? We go here and hit effects and curve. That's too much of a curve, but I just want a little bit to give it some interest like that. I just really love. Okay, now we can move these two. Remember there's two, so you're gonna have to kind of go over it like that. Really love. Cool. Okay, and then I'm gonna put anime and sketching. So I'm gonna use these same fonts here. So just hold down option and drag this. It's gonna be the same font, except I don't need the effect anymore, so I'm gonna take that off. And I'm gonna type in anime. See that nice rounded font? It's really cool, right? Thing I love about Canva is you can just drag the text to make it bigger. You don't have to worry about, I mean, you can use this and go up and down, but it's really simple to just drag it. So do about the same size and right about here. Yeah, that looks good. Center it. And you, the nice thing too is you can center the font. So you can see it kind of just locks right there and it's centered. So you don't have to worry if your thing's centered or not. Is this centered? Yep, right there. Is this centered? Yep, right there. So really cool. Okay, last thing. So let's do this. I'm gonna use this font right here. Option, drag it down. Make sure this is in the front. Yeah, front and sketching. Cool. Just to give it more interest, I'm gonna make this a little wider there. That's kind of cool. To give it a little more interest, because the word love here, I'm gonna add some hearts. So let's go to elements and type in hearts. Lots of different hearts again. Remember, we gotta use the free one, but if you're on Canva Pro, you can use any of these. So many hearts. Let's just do this one. Free heart. Or should I do, let's see if there's more rounded. So this one's kind of a classic one. I want it a more anime style, so more rounded. Like these. These are more rounded. Or these, but those are animated. So let's see. Yeah, this one's, I like this one. Let's get rid of this one. You can see this is sharper curves. This is a little, just a little bit more rounded to match our style. So always look for that stuff that can match. Let's see your recommendations. Yeah, these are some rounded ones. They're different colors, so we're gonna have to make sure we color it. So you can turn it like this and just make it any size. You know, holding down option again, copying, turning, kind of fitting that space here. I wanna flip this one. You can just go flip horizontal. Look at that. And these two fit right there, and you can turn it. Really cool. I love this color over this dark color. So I'm gonna click on these and copy this color. And I can do that by clicking on the color palette and just picking that lighter color. Same thing here. So I'm gonna just add a couple more hearts. Whoops. You can always hit Command Z, undo. That works too in Canva. So click on here, option and drag and turn. Maybe I want this one smaller, right there. Maybe I want this turned this way instead. I don't know. Just play around with it. Have fun. One more. Right here. Turn it. I don't know. Maybe outside of it. Just have fun like that. Yeah. Hey, that's looking good. The last thing I want to show you is I want to put some Japanese text here. So I'm going to go to the internet and type in I love anime in Japanese and then paste it here. So let me show you that right now. So here I am on Google Translate. I just typed in Google Translate into Google and I'm going to type in the words I love anime, right? So that's English. If I change this to Japanese, let's see, just type in Japanese. Boom, here it is. And I'm gonna just double click on these and copy it. So Command C, and then I'm gonna go back to here and let's just copy this down here, double click on it and Command V, paste it in. You can see it's right there, it's pretty cool. I'm gonna make this a lot smaller, so like 100. And we can make it bigger later. So let's get rid of, there we go. And I wanna find a really cool font for this. Let's just make it just a little bit bigger so you can see. So I want it more rounded and thicker. So one thing I found is I can type in Japanese here too. And there's some really cool ones. You see this one's pretty thick. That one's kind of nice. This one's nice and rounded, I believe. So look at that. That one's really cool, right? So just moving this around. Make sure that this is at the top. Yeah, it is. Okay. So now you have that. It's really neat. So there's the whole thing. I just really love anime and sketching, and this says I love anime on the bottom. Really cool, right? So I'm just gonna take this, I'm gonna download it right now and then knock out this black and then put it on a t-shirt. So just to finish it off, here I am on Merch by Amazon and I loaded it up on the t-shirt. I knocked out that background so you can see it looks good on different colors now. Navy, olive, red, that's a nice one. Dark heather looks really cool, brown and stuff like that. So have fun with this one. Hopefully you can use these same techniques, the arc text, the fonts, the background, that mass background, and Japanese text. Those are really gonna be important for your next one. I think you can do so many different designs with these techniques. You don't have to do anime, you can do other things out there. You can mask different designs on there and have this really cool look that gives you some interest right here, right? And so that's what you want. You want a design that creates interest that people are like, ooh, that's really different. I wanna buy that. So have fun with this, these techniques on Canva totally for free. Make up your own designs, don't copy this one. Come up with your own phrases and things like that and have fun with it and make t-shirts that people wanna buy. Before I leave this video, I wanted to ask you a question of the day, and the question of the day is this: what other topics do you wanna learn how to design for? Let me know in the comments. This one was for anime, but it could be anything. I'd love to help you out if you're designing for a specific topic and don't know what to do for it. Leave me a comment there. And thanks again for watching this video. If you want to see more design tutorials on Canva, make sure to click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.